The right to an adequate living standard includes health and well-being, medical care, and necessary social services during sickness and disability in circumstances beyond one's control. The global spread of COVID-19 is an example of one of those circumstances. Hello, good people. My name is Janice. I am an attorney, public speaker, human rights educator, and author of the upcoming book, Dignity, Human Rights in Daily Life. Thank you for stopping by. If you're new here, welcome. After watching this video, I invite you to check out this playlist and please consider subscribing. Around the globe, we are witnessing world leaders rising to the occasion of meeting the challenges of COVID-19. China built 2 hospitals in 12 days. South Korea created an infrastructure for automatic testing. Italy is closed,
while the U.S. tweets.
The lack of effective leadership at the federal level leaves states to do the best they can to protect the public.
The city of New York has been down this road before. It navigated uncharted territories while then Mayor Rudy Giuliani was busy taking victory laps for work he did not do.
I was a community leader at the time and had my boots on the ground. I documented what really took place in an article published by the New York State Bar Association's Government Law and Policy Journal titled Crisis Management in the Wake of 9/11. To make a long story short, in the weeks following 9/11, the local community leaders took personal responsibility for providing meals, filling prescriptions, and getting access to and for the elderly and disabled in the frozen zone. This gave us an opportunity to learn firsthand the needs and concerns of area residents. At the same time, the New York City Office of Emergency Management, OEM for short, which is charged with helping New Yorkers before, during, and after emergencies through preparedness, education, and response, was too overwhelmed with the rescue and recovery efforts to focus on residents and businesses. To fill the void, our U.S. Representative Jerry Nadler established the Ground Zero Elected Officials Task Force to address the initial problems of local residents and businesses and to present them to OEM with a prioritized list of issues. After the towers fell, we lost internet access and telephone lines, so we met regularly to keep everyone updated with new developments. At one of those meetings, Senator Nadler reported, OEM responded excellently and then stopped communication after 3 or 4 weeks. It was almost as though New York City didn't have a mayor anymore. In response to a recalcitrant administration, we were forced to take a more proactive role in serving the community and facilitating lines of communication. With COVID-19, it is the entire country that must take a proactive role in serving the public.
In the United States, the dangerous delays and testing still persists because the federal government has yet to take this pandemic seriously. Its refusal to allow states to administer automatic testing, its misinformation to the public, and the exponential increase of confirmed cases is the formula that's causing fear, confusion, and apprehension among the public.
The failures of the federal government notwithstanding, states did what they could in anticipation of the pandemic. New York State, for example, had been preparing since January. New York City, which is seasoned in managing catastrophic situations, has the advantage of world-class healthcare institutions to weigh in on the issue. Working in tandem with state officials, all key players are on the same page in managing this pandemic and providing information to the public. The mayor provides cogent information and takes into account the concerns of the residents and businesses. If he cannot answer a question, he'll give an honest response and then provide an answer in the following update.
While some of the information is specific to the city and the state, a lot of the information is universally applicable. For that reason, I urge you to text COVID to 692-692 to get practical and reliable information at your fingertips, because this pandemic is no joke. Please let me know what's going on locally where you are in the comments. Share this video and help the channel grow by subscribing. In the meantime, be well and remember to live your life with dignity. Bye-bye.